Each month on the island of Aragon, hundreds of soldiers and civilians are killed or injured in minefields emplaced by the Cortinian Liberation Force. The enemy uses these minefields to inflict serious physical and psychological damage to personnel, while depleting the combat power of the brigade combat team sent here to restore peace to this war-torn nation. The purpose of this presentation is to increase mine awareness in units across our army by demonstrating the effectiveness of these inexpensive munitions against armored vehicles and personnel. The footage that you are about to see was shot on a demo range in the Joint Readiness Training Center using both U.S. and foreign mines. The vehicles that you will see destroyed still had engines in them and were structurally intact. It is the hope of the Joint Readiness Training Center that units will incorporate this video in their own mine awareness training to show the potentially devastating consequences of these cheap and prevalent explosives. The first shot that you will see is of a VS-50 Italian anti-personnel mine detonating underneath the toe of a combat boot on a mannequin. The VS-50 contains 50 grams or 1.8 ounces of pressed RDX explosive. It is pressure fused and requires only 22 to 26.4 pounds of pressure to detonate. The mine is blast resistant and contains only 0.86 grams of metallic content, thus making it difficult to detect with a metallic mine detector. As you can see, the force of this blast blew off the toe section of a combat boot. The second shot that you will see is a TM-62P3 Russian anti-tank mine detonating under the number 2 road wheel on the left side track of the M-728 combat engineer vehicle. The TM-62P3 is a plastic cased mine, contains 18.3 pounds of TNT based explosive. The only metallic content is found in the fuse, and it can either be pressure or magnetically fused. The MVCH-62 pressure fuse requires 440 pounds of pressure to detonate and is designed to produce a mobility kill to armored vehicles. The VM-62Z magnetic fuse is designed to produce a catastrophic kill to armored vehicles that straddle it. The magnetic fuse also contains an anti-disturbance feature that will detonate the mine if it is moved. The CEV is based on the M60A1 chassis and weighs 54 tons. Note the damage to the track and the road wheels in this shot. The third shot that you will see is an M21 U.S. anti-tank mine detonating center line under the driver's compartment of the M551 Sheridan tank. The M21 contains 11 pounds of composition H6 explosive. The M607 fuse can be employed in either the pressure or tilt rod mode. In the pressure mode, the fuse requires 290 pounds of pressure to detonate it. In the tilt rod mode, the fuse requires 3.75 pounds to move the tilt rod, and once it exceeds 20 degrees of tilt, the mine will detonate. The mine contains a direct energy warhead that is designed to produce a catastrophic kill to armored vehicles that activate its tilt rod. The M551 Sheridan weighs 18 tons. Note the small hole in the hull of the driver's compartment caused by the direct energy warhead. Also note the exit hole by the driver's hatch. The fourth shot that you will see is an M15 U.S. anti-tank mine detonating at the intersection of a hard-packed road. The mine was buried under 3 inches of soil. The M15 is a blast-effect mine that contains 22 pounds of composition B explosive. It can be employed in either the pressure or tilt rod mode and is designed to produce a mobility kill to armored vehicles. The M603 pressure fuse requires between 350 to 750 pounds of pressure to detonate. The M624 tilt rod fuse requires 3.75 pounds of pressure to move the tilt rod, and once it exceeds 20 degrees of tilt, the mine will detonate. The purpose of this shot is to demonstrate cratering effects of an anti-tank mine on hard-packed surface. Note the size and depth of the hole created in the road surface. The fifth shot that you will see is an M15 U.S. anti-tank mine detonating under the number 2 road wheel on the left side track of an M551 Sheridan tank. The M551 Sheridan weighs 18 tons. Notice the damage to the track, road wheels, and road arm caused by the force of this blast. The sixth shot that you will see is a TM-62M Russian anti-tank mine, detonating center line under the engine compartment of the M113 armored personnel carrier. The TM-62M contains 15.9 pounds of TNT RDX-based explosive. It can either be pressure or magnetically fused and uses the same fuse as the TM-62P3 Russian anti-tank mine. The metallic content of the TM-62M mine is approximately 2.8 pounds, thus making it easy to detect with a metallic mine detector. The M113 APC weighs 13 tons. The force of this blast flipped the APC completely over, and the direct energy warhead penetrated the hull next to the driver's compartment. The seventh shot that you will see is an M15 U.S. anti-tank mine detonating under the number 2 road wheel on the left side track of an M113 armored personnel carrier. The M113 APC weighs 13 tons. As you can see, the force of the M15 blast flipped the APC on its side and sheared both the road wheels and the road arm. The eighth shot that you will see is a TM-62M Russian anti-tank mine, detonating under the right front tire of the M35A2 2.5-ton cargo truck. The M35A2 2.5-ton cargo truck weighs 8 tons. Notice the shrapnel hitting the dummy standing approximately 30 feet from the blast. This blast lifted the front end of the vehicle several feet in the air. Notice the extensive damage to the right front of the vehicle. The ninth shot that you will see is an M21 U.S. anti-tank mine detonating centerline under the engine compartment of the M728 combat engineer vehicle. Simultaneous to the M21 detonation, you will see a 15-pound TNT equivalent satchel charge of C4 explosives detonating in the right rear sprocket. The CEV is based on the M60A1 chassis and weighs 54 tons. Yeah. Notice the piece of sprocket being sheared away by the blast from the small satchel charge. Note the small hole in the hull of the engine compartment caused by the direct energy warhead. Also note the destroyed rear sprocket caused by the satchel charge, and the crater from the M21 anti-tank mine. The tenth shot that you will see is the near simultaneous detonation of satchel charges on two M551 Sheridan tanks. The Sheridan on the right side of the road TNT equivalent charge placed on the top of the left side track. The Sheridan on the left side of the road contains a 10-pound TNT equivalent satchel charge located on the commander's cupola. The M551 Sheridan weighs 18 tons. Note the structural breach into the crew compartment by the satchel charges below the commander's cupola and above the left side track. The 11th shot that you will see is the detonation of a 2-pound TNT equivalent satchel charge placed on the empty fuel tank of the M35A2 2.5-ton cargo truck. The M35A2 2.5-ton cargo truck weighs 8 tons. The force of this small blast moved the truck and completely destroyed the empty fuel tank located just in front of the rear tires. The 12th and final shot that you will see is an M19 US anti-tank mine detonating under the left front wheel of an M151 Jeep. The M19 is a blast effect mine that contains 21 pounds of TNT and composition B based explosive. It is a pressure fused mine that is designed to produce a mobility kill to armored vehicles. The M606 pressure fuse requires from 300 to 500 pounds of pressure to detonate the mine. The M151 Jeep weighs 1.5 tons. Detonation, the Jeep was tossed over 25 meters from its original location. The dummy in the driver's seat was wearing a flak vest and holding a Pepsi can. The flak vest was ripped from the dummy's body and contained shrouds of metal from both the Jeep and the Pepsi can. From this video, anti-personnel and anti-tank mines can be extremely effective weapons on the battlefield. Once in place, these munitions do not differentiate between friend or foe. Therefore, it is imperative that units develop effective counter-mine tactics, techniques, and procedures for improving force protection within their areas of operation. The potential consequences of not doing so can be devastating.